Hi everybody, welcome to the session of electric circuits. In this session I would like to discuss parallel resonance. Regarding that, I am going to consider a simple parallel circuit in which two branches I am going to consider. In one branch, series combination of resistance and inductance, and the second branch consists of a pure capacitor. I am going to consider the currents as shown, the total current as I, and the current passing through this branch as IL, and the current passing through the capacitor as IC. The concept of resonance remains the same whether it is series or parallel. Ultimately, the power factor should be unity, or the circuit has to behave like a pure resistive circuit. So here, in the case of parallel resonance, in order to achieve that, we have to get the circuit condition such that the reactive component of the current has to become equal to zero. That means to say that the total current I should have only the active component. That condition of the circuit is said to be parallel resonance condition. Here, as these two are connected in parallel, we are going to have the current passing through the inductor circuit via IL is given as V by Z, where Z is the impedance of this series circuit, which is given as R plus jXL, and the magnitude of Z is equal to square root of R square plus XL square. And here we can also have the phase angle R cos phi, which is equal to R by Z, where phi is the power factor of this particular combination. In order to achieve the condition for parallel resonance, I consider the vector diagram considering the voltage as the reference. So if V is the voltage that I am going to consider it as the reference, the current passing through the inductor IL is going to lag behind by an angle of phi with respect to the voltage. And when we divide this IL into two components along the horizontal axis and along the vertical axis, this will be IL cos phi, and this will be the vertical component will be IL sin phi. And we know that the current passing through the capacitor IC is going to lead the voltage by 90 degrees. Say this is equal to IC. The magnitude of IC is given as V by XC, where XC is the capacitive reactance of the capacitor. We can find out the value of XC as equal to 1/2πfC. All these things we have seen in our previous lectures. Now if you observe carefully this phasor diagram, the component of current which is in phase with the supply voltage is nothing but IL cos phi. And we are going to have two reactive components of current. One is IC and another one is IL sin phi, which are acting in opposite directions. So if the magnitudes of these two currents are same, then obviously the net reactive component of the current becomes equal to zero, and the total current will have only the active component, which is given by IL cos phi. Hence, the condition for this resonance, for this circuit, is nothing but the two currents should be the same, which are acting in opposite directions. So here, the condition for parallel resonance for this circuit is given as IC is equal to IL sin phi, so that these two are going to cancel each other, and keeping the total current as the active component, which is IL cos phi. And we know that IC is equal to V by XC, and this is equal to IL is equal to V by Z, and sin phi is given as XL by Z. So here V is going to be cancelled on both sides, and we are going to have Z square. If you cross multiply, we are going to have Z square is equal to XL into XC, and we know XL is given as omega L, and XC is equal to 1 by omega C. So we are going to have the condition as Z square is equal to L by C, or Z is equal to square root of L by C. This is the condition for the parallel resonance. And from the same equation, we can also find out the magnitude of the resonant frequency also. And we know that the magnitude of impedance is given as square root of R square plus XL square, which is equal to square root of L by C. So the square root is going to be taken out on the both sides. We are going to have R square plus XL square is given as omega square into L square, which is equal to L by C. And solving for this equation for omega, we are going to have the magnitude of omega is equal to square root of 1 by LC minus R by L whole square. This is the formula for finding out the resonant angular frequency. And once we find out omega, you can find out the magnitude of F is equal to omega by 2 pi. So you can consider that as FR, that is resonant frequency, which is equal to omega by 2 pi. And after that, next we shall also calculate the current at resonance. So which is given as the current, total current at resonance, I is equal to, just now we have seen that IL cos phi. So IL is nothing but V by Z, and cos phi is nothing but R by Z, which is equal to V into R by Z square. So this is the formula for finding out the current at resonance, which will have no reactive component and only active component. And we know Z square is equal to L by C. Already we have seen here Z square is equal to L by C for parallel resonance condition. So now we are going to have V into R by, if we substitute that, we are going to have V into R by L by C. And this can also be written as V by, so if you take this R to the denominator, we are going to have L by RC. So now finally we are going to have the equation of current as equal to V by L by RC. So here the denominator, if you observe, this is nothing but a ohmic component, because current is equal to the voltage over some parameter. Obviously that parameter should be ohmic component. Hence we are going to consider this denominator as the dynamic impedance or characteristic impedance. So ZC, which is equal to L by RC. That is how we are going to consider the resonance in parallel circuit. This is an example. And even we can represent, we can have the graphical representation of this parallel resonance. Almost all the graphical representation of parallel resonance will be quite opposite to that of the series resonance. And one more important thing that we have to discuss here is, here the current at resonance is going to be minimum, because it is going to have only the active component, and the reactive component is going to be equal to zero. As the current is going to be minimum, this particular circuit is considered as a rejector circuit, whereas we have considered the series resonant circuit as acceptor circuit. But here the parallel resonant circuit is a rejector circuit, because here the current is minimum and the impedance will be maximum. So if you consider the graphical representation of this particular, say this is the frequency we are going to consider on x-axis, and here let me write down some equations. The admittances we have to consider here. So here y is the admittance, total admittance we are going to have. It is going to have two components. One is conductance G, and another one is susceptances. Here we are going to have two susceptances. One is inductive susceptance, which is given as 1 by omega L, and capacitive susceptance, which is equal to omega into C, quite opposite to the reactances. So here the conductance is a constant one with respect to the frequency, hence I am going to represent parallel to the frequency. So here this is the conductance axis we are going to have, and BC, that is capacitive susceptance, is proportional to the frequency. So proportional to frequency, hence this is a constant which is passing through origin. Say this is BC, and BL is inversely proportional to 1 by frequency. So this is a hyperbola we are going to have like this. So this is BL, and the net susceptance is going to be, net susceptance B is going to be BL minus BC. So if you calculate that, that is going to be represented with the dotted line. So this is going to be the net susceptance B. At this point where the two magnitudes are equal, we are going to have zero susceptance, and the total admittance will be equal to the conductance. So if you draw the graph of this admittance we are going to have, this is the graphical representation of the admittance. Initially it is going to have the maximum values. At exactly this resonance point at FR where the two susceptances are equal, this will be of only purely the conductance, it will have only the conductance component. So that is how we can represent the parallel resonance graphically. This concludes the session. In the next session, I will deal with some more concepts related to AC circuits. Subscribe to my channel and watch my videos. Thank you.